The next thing is you need to know about two very important words called as projections, projection and selection. And these are the two words that actually simplify your learning of SQL. Projection means the number of columns that you want to output, nothing but projecting the columns in the output. So projection means selecting the columns. So projection means projecting or selecting the columns from a specific table. So how do you select all the columns? By specifying star, right? Selection means restricting rows from the table. So let me rephrase this one, restricting columns from the table. Now this becomes simplified, right? So projection means restricting the columns in the output. Selection means restricting the rows from the table. So your select statement helps you to project and also select the records from the output. Now how it is done? If you use select star from hr.employee, the command that we have already used, in this command we are projecting all the columns. Can you see we have all the columns? Now with this command, select email from hr.employees, and let us see what happens. In this case, I am only projecting one single column in the output. So that means we are restricting the number of columns in the output. So with this select statement, always remember guys, the syntax rules, very simple rules. Projection is nothing but restricting the columns from the table. And then selection, restricting the rows from the table. Now this selection part I'll be discussing when we are working with the WHERE clause, which we are about to work technically. So now with the select command, we know the syntax rules, we know the projection that we can project the specific columns. We can also restrict the number of rows in the output by selecting the rows. Now the question is, how do we select the rows? When I use the WHERE clause, I want you to focus on this condition once again. So first of all, let us try to query the HR table. So select star from hr.employee. Let me run this command. So I think this will reset the database connection once again. Okay, so I think it should run now. Great. So how do we restrict the rows in the output? You use a simple WHERE clause. So select star from hr.employees, and then you use WHERE clause, where column name equal to a value. So for example, where last underscore name is equal to, and I want to query all the employees whose last name is King. Okay, now in this case I want to go back to this syntax rule. When you specify conditions, be specific about the case. Now that we want to query every employee whose last name is King, it is stored in this format inside the database. So you have to be very careful with the format. You have to specify it like the way it is stored inside the database. Okay, now let us run this one and then we'll see how we are able to select the records in the output. So there are two employees whose last name is King the way it is specified, and we have selected all the columns of the table. Now when it is a character, remember guys, every column will have its own data type. When it is a character or a date data type, then you will have to specify those single quotes. And if it is a number column or a column that only stores the number, then you don't need to specify these single quotes. So for example, select star from hr.employees, where I am selecting all the employees who are in the department ID 80. So let us query it, department underscore ID equal to 80. Now this time, if you see, we did not specify the single quotes because it is only used for character column or a date column. Okay, so let me highlight and run this query. Now we see the output. Because we have a star, we are getting all the columns from the table. So we are projecting all the columns. But when it comes to rows or the records, we are selecting only the records where the department ID is 80. If you scroll all the records in this result, you will see that department ID is only 80 because we have specified a where clause. So just to remind you guys, this single quote will be only used when you are specifying the data the way it is stored inside the database. Now in this case, if let's take, I put it like king, and let me run this query and we'll see the output. So what happens? No output, because now Oracle is comparing the last name column with the exact string or the exact characters that you provided under these single quotation marks. So no last name has king in this case, nothing but all in uppercase. But if we give it like king, definitely we'll get the output. And now let us go for lowercase. I'll make the k also in the lowercase and run the query, and then we'll see the output. No output. Right? So when you specify a condition or a character in the where clause, or you want to specify or compare the data with the exact data that is stored inside a table, then case does matter when it comes to characters or date data types. For the numbers, definitely there is no case. Number is just a number. So for numbers, you can specify them directly.